In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this material by using a texture node with a color ramp node. Let's create a UV sphere. I'll align its bottom with the world center. Control 3 to subdivide. Right-click to shade smooth. I'll move the render camera with Shift, backquote, shortcut and use W, A, S, D, Q, E keys along with the mouse to position the camera. Let's create a metallic material. I'll hide the ground plane for now, so we can see the material pattern better. I'm using Forest EXR file as the HDRI. Please watch the tutorial in the description if you don't know how to use the Forest EXR file. What will happen if we directly connect a noise texture node to the color node? We'll lose the golden color, because color node is now using a numeric values from the texture node. If we connect the texture node's color to the color node, we get a random numeric-based color data. The best way to change the color would be using a hue and saturation node, but the color ramp works far better than any other nodes. While keeping the default colors, the noise texture pattern becomes clearly visible. If the color ramp node's colors are too similar, we won't be able to notice the texture node's patterns. Let's take a look at these two examples here. I'm using a Voronoi for one, and a noise for another. We can create a detailed patterned material like this just by using any texture nodes along with the color ramp node. The positions of the sliders are very important when making a patterned material from a texture node. The Voronoi is giving us a dotted look of the material. They look all lined up, because I have set its randomness value to 0. Please remember to experiment with all other texture nodes available in Blender's node editor. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.